Hey everyone, I'm Mike, and today I'm going to show you how to fix the content decoding failed error. Trusted browsers like Google Chrome, Microsoft Edge, and Firefox make it easy to navigate the web. However, none of these services are immune to errors like the pesky content decoding failed error. The good news is that this error is quite easy to fix. In this video, I will show you 6 ways to fix this error. But before we get started, I want to let you know that there'll be links to more resources in the video's description. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. Now, let's do some troubleshooting and get rid of this error. A firewall can protect your device from online threats. However, it can also cause the content decoding failed error. You can check to see if this is the case by disabling the firewall. First, let's see how to do this on a Mac device. To get started, go to System Preferences, and then Security and Privacy. Then, navigate to the Firewall tab. At this point, you may see your firewall is off. However, if it's on, select the lock in the bottom left corner of the window. You'll be prompted to enter your password before you can continue. Then, you'll be able to modify your security settings. Select Turn Off Firewall, and click on the lock again to save your changes. On a Windows device, the process is just as easy. You'll need to go to Control Panel, and then System, and then Privacy and Security. Then, select Windows Security and click on Firewall and Network Protection to manage your firewalls. When you're ready, return to your browser and check to see if this has resolved the issue. If you're still getting this error message, the issue may be with your cached data. Caching can speed up your content delivery, but if you don't clear out your browser cache every once in a while, it can create complications. Cookies can also be problematic. So let's look at how to wipe them out along with the cache. Open Google Chrome and click on the 3 dots in the upper right-hand corner of your screen. Then go to More Tools, and then Clear Browsing Data. You'll now see the following pop-up window. To be safe, we recommend choosing All Time for your time range. Then, make sure to select cookies and other site data, as well as cached images and files. Hit Clear Data and return to the web page that was giving you the content decoding failed error. If it's still not loading, you can move on to the next step. GZIP compression can be a great way to improve a website's performance. However, if something goes wrong during the compression process, it may trigger a content decoding failed error. So, we're going to show you how to disable GZIP encoding. To do this, you'll need to use a Chrome extension like Mod Header, Modify HTTP Headers. Simply go to the extension page and select Add to Chrome. You'll then see a pop-up alert notifying you that this extension can read and change data on your websites. Click on Add Extension to continue. This will automatically open the mod header dashboard, but you can go ahead and close the screen. Instead, click on the mod header icon next to your navigation bar. Under Request Headers, locate the empty field for name and input this data into the appropriate fields as shown in this example. Now, GZIP compression has been disabled in your browser. Simply, return to the page that was throwing the error to see if it's working. If it's still not fixed, you may want to remove the Chrome extension and proceed to the next step. Your DNS configuration can be another possible reason you're getting the content decoding failed error message. Therefore, you might want to change your DNS server addresses to see if this solves the problem. Chances are your current device is running the default settings provided by your internet service provider. But don't worry, they are easy to modify. In any case, remember to take note of your original server address, just in case you want to revert back to it. On a Mac device, start by going to System Preferences and then Network. Make sure Wi-Fi is selected and hit Advanced. Then, navigate to the DNS tab. Now we're going to replace the server address with Google's public DNS. To do this, simply click on the plus icon in the bottom left-hand corner. Then enter 8.8.8.8 and/or 8.8.4.4. These are Google's IPv4 addresses. Alternatively, you can enter Google's IPv6 addresses. Finally, click on OK to save your changes. On a Windows device, open the Settings app and select Network and Internet. Then, click on Properties. On the next page, locate IP Assignment and click on the Edit button. This will launch a pop-up window. Choose Manual, then turn on the toggle switch for IPv4. Enter the IP addresses in the appropriate field and hit save. If reconfiguring your DNS server addresses didn't resolve your browser issue, it may be time to flush your DNS entirely. To do this on a Mac, you need to use Terminal. You can look for this application using the Spotlight search tool. Once you have terminal open, enter the following command and hit enter. You'll then need to input your admin password. Hit enter again and you should see a confirmation that your DNS has been flushed. On Windows, the process is equally simple. You need to open the command prompt application and input the following. Now return to the page in question to see if it's still showing the content decoding failed error. If any of the methods haven't worked for you so far, there's one more strategy you might want to try. That's flushing your browser's socket pools. Just open a new tab in Chrome and type the following address into your search bar. This will take you to the following page. Go to Sockets in the left-hand menu, then click on the Flush Socket Pools button. Now return to the page throwing the content decoding failed message and see if it's working. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. We offer 2 months free with any annual plan, a 30-day money-back guarantee, and unlimited free basic migrations from any host. Head over to kinsta.com/plans to get started. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.